Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Ninth Legion. Let's play some more Firewatch. Where we're on the way to shout at some teenage girls. Because that's mostly what my job is, apparently. Shouting at teenage girls. I mean, they are trying to burn down the wilderness, so they do entirely deserve it. And man, we are really hiking our way around the wilderness. I think we're coming back up towards where my watchtower is? Where am I? Okay, I'm near to it. But not quite there. Okay, so I want to keep... Yeah, I want to head down to Cripple Gulch. What the... What? There's a turtle sitting upright out of the log.
Whoa, I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise? It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
It's actually pretty cute.
It's adorable.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Now, what do I call it? Looks like a,
This ought to be good.
Turt Reynolds, Shelley Duvall, Bucket Jr., or keep it a secret. It's gotta be Turt Reynolds.
Turt Reynolds.
Well, now I can't wait to see him.
The mustache is impressive.
You tell him I love Cannonball Run.
Okay, I have now adopted Turt Reynolds as my own. He is mine. Oh, we've got another blocked trail. Wonder where that goes. Okay. Oh, it just gives me a shortcut. The tiniest of shortcuts. That's okay. We don't mind that. Okay. Okay, yeah, my lookout is 800 feet in that direction. I don't really need to go back there yet. We need to head down to Jonesy Lake. We've already unlocked that supply box. I'm still laughing at Turt Reynolds. I will never not laugh at Turt Reynolds.
So, how'd you meet?
Oh yeah, I was drunk in a bar.
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty, and that was it.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
Have we looked up there yet? I know there's possibly a fire burning out of control in the wilderness, but I don't know if we've looked up here. We might find another raccoon. Or a cave. I'd be kind of happy with either. No, apparently I found a good view, but Delilah doesn't want to talk about it. Where does this go? I'm going in completely the wrong direction now. I'm just randomly wandering off and exploring, because it's so pretty and... really peaceful. They've done a very good job with the sound of the wind in the trees and stuff. But I suppose I do need to go save the wilderness, don't I? Okay. Am I still heading in the right direction? Yeah. I know where I am. That's the jacked up tree that the bears are using to sharpen their claws. That column of smoke, is that getting bigger? Or am I just getting closer? Kind of feel like it's getting bigger. Ah, good old Cripple Gulch to try to kill me earlier. Luckily, we do now have better rope. I was going to say newer rope, but we found it in an abandoned backpack on the side of a mountain, so it's probably quite old. But it, at least it's holding up better than the last one. Okay, we know they're not quite by Jonesy Lake, are they? No, we actually need to turn off here. And go... Aha! We need to go down here. Really don't like the fact you can't look behind you when you're rappelling down. I was worried there's not going to be something behind me when I turn around. This was more of a horror game.
What are you going to do when the fire season wraps up?
That's a good question.
With her, just go back to Boulder? You should go be with her. That's my opinion. Sorry for the umpteenth time. Anyway, call me when you find the girls. Or anything. Or call me whenever you want.
That's a very good question. I have no idea.
I don't know. I haven't really thought about it. Right now, I'm trying to hunt down some vandals, and I don't even know what I'm going to do when I find them. I'm not thinking very far ahead.
You should go see her.
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better, and that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it.
That's kind of pretty. Camera time. And we've got another supply cache to open up. Nope, hang on. There we go. I like how we're opening all of these up, but we never lock them back up afterwards. Also, they're generally full of rubbish, like pine cones and fossils.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. Just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
You really didn't like that guy, did you?
I don't know. I just had a hard time talking to him. I mean, there are lookouts who seriously won't shut up, who call me about every little thing that pops into their head. And then there are those who just want to be left alone. He was the latter.
And I'm the former, aren't I?
Well, I didn't want to say anything.
No, it's fine. I'll just chuck my walkie-talkie into the river.
Oh, come on.
And you'll never hear from me again.
Finally, peace and quiet. Woohoo!
So,
isn't your radio supposed to be in the river?
I couldn't bring myself to do it.
Well, I guess I'm stuck with you then.
Yeah. You said Ned didn't get mauled by a grizzly, but it's possible, right?
Yeah, I guess it's possible, but we usually find evidence of stuff like that. For instance, if you were to be hunted down and torn to shreds, I'm sure someone would come across a bloody beard and shredded pair of ugly cargo shorts.
I like these shorts.
I'm sure you do, Henry.
Okay. That's fine.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Okay, we definitely have the stream. And I did not know that about aspen trees. So, I actually learned something new today. This game, seriously, this is so pretty. Just the light, the orange colours, really done a good job with this, seriously. Just one of the reasons I'm playing through it for the third time, but hey. Okay, I want to keep heading. Oh. There we go.
Found one of their empties. Guess we're on the right track.
Roger that.
Anything else around here? I mean, I'm spending most of my time tidying up after these two girls and their alcoholism. Oh wow, there's actually quite a big area over here. I'm mostly thinking it's another photo opportunity. Oh, here we are.
Hey, what's to the south of here?
Mexico? Is this some sort of riddle?
I just have a nice view to the south. You know, trees and mountains forever.
Well, eventually you'll wander into the area overseen by Chimney Rock Lookout, but that's probably an impossible hike in terms of terrain.
Yeah, those do look like peaks you don't really want to try and walk over. They do, however, look like peaks you want to try and take a photo of. Nice. Okay, let's go shout at some girls. I think that smoke is gone. I'm not seeing it anymore. Maybe their campfires died out.
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
Don't think I've actually been in this corner. Is there anything over here? I'm not seeing much. Just enjoying looking around. Nope, okay. Gotta go do my job. Saving the wilderness from nudie teenagers.
Found another.
Roger that.
Yeah, I see what she means about us talking to her too much. We are reporting every single beer can we find.
There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around.
No more beer cans, at least.
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is.
Alright, stomp out the fire to prevent fires. What have we got? Oh, hang on.
Ah, found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like.
I knew we couldn't trust those naked teenagers.
I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp.
Pants are back. Did pants ever go anywhere?
Pants are back.
I'm sorry, pants are back?
Well, according to the experts at Teen Zone magazine, it's unclear where they've been. The pants, I mean?
Am I meant to, as, you know, as my current age, relate to these 40-year-olds as much as I am right now? Where the hell did pants go?
Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines. I don't get why the hunks have to be so dangerous.
Well, you're clearly not a young woman.
Girls should want nice hunks.
Ugh, boring.
These girls have a full case of beer left here, a full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
I mean, I wish we had a count of how many beer cans we've picked up so far, because it's been a lot of beer. I am seriously impressed with their stamina. That is not a good sign, though.
Your tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear, or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking.
That doesn't look good.
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
Okay. Dear Psycho, I hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us in the lake. And then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. That's not even a word. You're probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick. I like how they put a little heart at the end of that. Okay, so they think I did this? They think I tore up their tent.
Well, they're gone, for sure.
How can you tell?
Well, the girls left someone, me, I guess, a note.
Well, what's it say?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, of course not.
Don't be ridiculous.
It's not ridiculous. I've known you, what, 24 hours? Maybe you're nuts.
Look, I just came out here to sit in a tower, all right? Not get into some mess with a bunch of co-eds.
It's fine. They're gone?
Yeah, they're gone. But you should see this place. It's just... it's weird.
Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know. But they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back. And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, there we go. That was our second day on the job, guys. Our second day we've dealt with fires and fireworks and teenagers and a lot of crap, let's be honest. Find boards downstairs. So we're patching up our broken window that someone broke, possibly the teenagers.
Hey, Henry.
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Can't you see me from your tower? You've got like a telescope over there or something. Like Burt Reynolds? Tom Cruise had a good looking twin. I don't know who Rolly Fingers is. Let's go for Burt Reynolds.
Unless you just don't want to answer.
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Oh, is that so?
Women say that we have a similar musk.
You.
Hey, you asked.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then... what do you normally like to wear?
Yeah, clothes.
Clothes. I don't really think about it.
Oh, come on.
I got a sweatshirt I like. Good jacket I got at the Buckle Barn.
Ooh, I love the Buckle Barn.
Just one of those brown ones, you know?
I do. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
I do have a beard. We know that from the picture of me upstairs.
Beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes. Tell me.
What are my eyes like? Steely, happy, or tired? I'm gonna go with tired after everything we've been through recently.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you just... you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished.
Some people
got
might.
It. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, let's fix up our window, shall we? Man. Henry's pretty good with a hammer. One hit to get all those nails in. That's not bad. I can't do that.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to you.
Turt Reynolds! We have adopted a turtle. Oh, well, actually, I think he's a tortoise, technically. I don't know if I can tell the difference, but he looks to be a tortoise. And if he's a turtle, he's going to get pretty dry in there, I think. So, we've actually got a break in the game here. We can reply to say we're ready to start, and that will take us on to the next section of the game. Or we can, you know, we can actually have a look around. We can go for a wander. We can... Oh, hang on, my photo from Julia's fallen over. So there you go, that's Julia, that's me. You can see I do have a beard. I don't think my nose has been broken, so... I'm always happy to go with that answer. Let's see. Ooh, Destrals. Escape from two orcs. What do we got? Witch's House, Gladius Silver's Ancestral Home, Two Orcs Lair, Magic Circle, Blood River, Death Mountain, Doom Canyon, The Scorched Lands. Interesting.
Hey, there's a map in my tower that I'm pretty sure is not USGS regulation. Unless I've unknowingly been assigned to work in two orcs, and the lake to the east is made of acid?
That sounds erroneous.
Looks like the previous resident was into fantasy. Assume it was Brian Goodwin. Kid must have really liked wizards. Yeah, looks like he was big into wizards.
You don't like wizards?
Well, hang on, who doesn't love wizards?
Who doesn't love wizards?
Wyverns.
Excuse me?
Winged reptiles with magical or unusual abilities. They soar over the land, scorching townships with their breath of flame, taking considerable care to devour their sworn enemies. The sorcerers, mages, witches, and, you know.
What?
The wizards.
Yeah, the wizards.
Holy shit.
Is Delilah a nerd?
Yeah, that fantasy map from before looks like it was made by Brian Goodwin. The handwriting matches everything in that folder I found.
Hmm. Maybe it just fell out a while back?
I guess.
I found a folder. When did I find a folder? I don't know. I want to put that back. Oh, hang on. Oh, cool, there's a D20. Oh man, that's some D&D level shit. And I can say that because I played D&D. I actually DM a D&D game at the moment for 7 of my friends. So, quick point for people. If you want to start playing D&D, don't agree to do it for 7 people. It's a lot of work. We've been doing it for a couple of months now. And it's fun, but Jesus, it's a lot of work. I started off with 4 players and then... Just everyone else, all my friends wanted to join. I've had to turn people away now. It's a little bit ridiculous, but we are having a lot of fun. And if any of my friends are watching this, because all my friends should be watching this to support me, then yeah, you guys are doing great. And I haven't killed any of you yet. Yet. Okay, what do we want to do? Do we want to go exploring? Is there anywhere we haven't really been yet? No, we've looked around most of the areas we've had to go through so far, so. I think, with how things are at the moment, we're ready for work.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a... splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Okay, there we go. Day 9. So time does skip ahead quite a lot in this, you know. We're here for 3 months, and this isn't a massively long game. Oh man, now I'm really hungry for lunch.
Having a nice afternoon?
Well, I was. That's a bit too harsh to say.
I might never leave.
Well, I come up with some bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
Oh, shit. I didn't do anything. It's probably a coincidence. They sound like something a guilty person would say. We didn't do anything wrong, so...
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
No, I don't think trying to hide this is... It's never a good idea. It's always worth being honest.
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
That sounds like Delilah's got something to hide. Okay, day 15. Wow, time is really jumping ahead now. We've been here for 2 weeks.
Henry. Henry, wake up. Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
Hey, Turt. You okay, dude? Oh, he looks sleepy. I like that. Let's turn the light on. Alright. Oh, there we go.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
It's Julia, my wife.
You're a big dumb idiot.
Oh, baby, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
Well, that's good.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Okay, so... There's no way Julia could be radioing me all the way from Australia. That's just not a thing that can happen.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Okay, wheelbarrows of marijuana it is. Okay, well, I think this episode's...
Two weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night. You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
It was quite a nice conversation, even if it was, you know, all in my head. I think I am doing okay.
I am.
Good. I'm glad. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. He's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper.
A driller,
eh? For almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Walls was also a good excuse to get Head out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. So, I lied to you. I came out here with a broken heart just like you. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Wow. Delilah's really opening herself up to us. Okay. Well, I think we're done for the moment there, so I'm going to take a break. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you are still enjoying this. Do leave a like, leave a comment, feel free to subscribe, and hopefully, I'll see you later for the next one. Bye!